residents is you want to go to a place where you're exposed to the largest number and widest breadth of types of patients that you can see. And really, Mayo's unparalleled for that. You know, the problems that you'll see, the medical histories that you'll take, the clinical intervention that you'll be a part of, it's unparalleled.
Mayo Clinic is really pushing the boundaries of innovation in a lot of different spaces, including drug development, biologics, device development, and theranostics. And I think to be exposed to those types of technology really helps the medical growth of our residents.
I would say all of my expectations have been wildly exceeded. You know, having an expert command of the diagnostic imaging, using the latest techniques and technologies, you can have an immense impact on patient care.
I think some of the procedures that we're doing here at Mayo are really advancing complex treatment of patients.
So the best part of the IR training program is the one-on-one interaction with the staff. There's about 13 consultants in the VIR division. And what I tell our residents is by the time you're done, you're gonna have a little piece of each one of those 13 people.
The one thing that surprised me about Mayo, the way in which you can be working next to the staff you're assigned to for the day, just that's the person on the schedule, and they happen to be a leading expert in their field.
I have seen classes of residents come through when they first start in interventional radiology, knowing just the basics, and now they're very capable, qualified physicians.
There is a mentor program here, and obviously that's one-on-one, and it's completely focused on me, near-term, long-term goals. The single biggest factor in my decision to come here was the residents. Basically made me feel right at home. The camaraderie I had with my co-residents and, you know, the way in which we all help lift each other up. And you also are exposed to very high volumes, critically ill patients overnight in a basically autonomous setting, which really helps kind of push you to the next level. And, you know, I think being in that environment has been critical to facilitating my, you know, academic and professional development.
I have seen classes of residents come through when they first start in interventional radiology, knowing just the basics, and now they're very capable, qualified physicians, and they keep me on my toes as well.
Friends, family, co-workers that I had matched to the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, the first thing everybody told me was, you know, it's cold up there. I have a four-wheel drive car, I have an apartment with an underground heated garage, but that was kind of more out of paranoia. The value of the Mayo Clinic definitely may outweigh concerns about the winter weather.
In general, Rochester's a great place to raise a family. It's safe, it's easy to get around. There are a lot of different activities. If you like being outdoors, you can take your kiddos to the park or on the numerous walking trails.
The only limitations you have here are yourself. I would say Mayo's unique in that that patient-centric model, that multidisciplinary approach where everybody weighs in with their own area of expertise to do the best for that patient, and that's the only interest that's considered at that given time is the patient that's sitting in front of you in your office or on your procedure table or in your scanner.
I'm really trying to make sure that I become the best diagnostic and interventional radiologist I can be, and it's a great place to train.
It doesn't matter where you start or what institution you come from or how much experience you have. When you come here, we're going to teach you the Mayo way of taking care of patients and that patient-centric model of care, so that when you finish on your last day of training, we can all have a big smile on our face and push you out the door because you're ready to be that independent interventional radiologist.